Hey everyone, welcome back to Write with Ink. Today, we are going to design a very special song, which is... Thank you so much, Steve, for your awesome and fantastic cover. You can follow his IG account, which is on the screen. Now, without further ado, let us start by preparing our stuffs. Firstly, make sure you have your trusty ink. Uncap it and pour it into any saucer that you can find in your kitchen. Make sure the saucer is about 3/4 full. Next, we can take our brush and gently, slowly dip it into the ink. Make sure it is fully wet. Before writing any calligraphy, you must actually motivate yourself and tell yourself that you can actually do it. And the most important thing is to plan and to wait, what is he doing? No, this is going to go very wrong. Oh no. Okay, you can see the brush going around, flying around, yeah. And you also can see this guy is actually using a lot of strength and pushing the brush slowly and surely, making the strokes strong. Oh no, this is bad. This is... He actually is making a mistake, but... never mind. Here comes my favorite part. Enough of that. Now we are going to write the small prints. The technique used is much more sophisticated, that involves writing only with the tip of the brush, and thus more boring to watch, so I just speed it up. 8 times, I think. While this is going, I'm just going to explain my idea behind the first one. I was going to make the first word of the song the largest and the rest of the words small, because most of the lines start with the word way, which means because, which is also the main gist of the song, so I want to emphasize it a lot. But this is the mistake I made. 2 very big words in one piece of art will ruin the work. You will understand what I say later. Up until this point, I think I feel like I have made the mistake, but I chose to go with it because I don't want to waste my paper, and the paper is very, very expensive. And this is also a good time for me to practice the big, big word. Now you can see I repeating the same steps, and I made more emphasis to the strokes so that it look more tight and look more firm. Yeah, the word will look better in a sense. This is the part where the mistake really shows itself. As you can see, when I'm writing the small prints, the prints start to look smaller and smaller because I'm trying to cram everything in one place. And this is where everything crumbles down. I do not have enough space to write the remaining words, and it will clash with the big, big word. So, yeah. Since my first try was screwed up, so I decided to go with my another strategy or planning, which is writing a lot of big words in one piece of art, which contains multiple small prints. As I mentioned in the first piece, this is a very big mistake that I've made, which will cause very big imbalance to the piece, which indefinitely make the piece look really bad. So here's the footage of it screwing up. After some deep thoughts and an hour, I've run several examples inside my head, and I feel like this is the best way to bring out this piece of art. But it might not be as good as expected. Okay, as you can see, I'm repeating the same steps. You can see the brush flying here and there, and I'm making some strokes and making sure that every stroke is made with strength and with meaning. so that it will make the word more powerful and more better looking. Now I'm gonna make a little mistake here, but I try to save it, and tada, I managed to save it. Here comes my favorite part, and I try to have some style with it. These small prints are very similar to what I did in the first one, just that the only difference here is I emphasize a bit on the first character of each line to make it more meaningful and more enjoyable. Oh, I accidentally smudged my paper, so I tried to save it and it was savable, luckily. As for the fourth line and the last line, which you will see later, I made it slightly bigger than the smaller prints, but very small compared to the big word. This is to make sure that the meaning, because like all poems, the song also, the heavy meaning contains at the fourth and the last line. For the second half of the chorus, I took the same approach as just now, but the first line was crisscrossed a bit so that the words will not intersect or cross with the big word. As you can see now, it's just normal writing, but oh no, I made a small mistake here. Hopefully you didn't see it, it's a smudge. But as I continue writing, my camera unfortunately went out of power, so here's the angle from my another camera. And as I'm writing finish, I hesitated a bit and my legs started to hurt a lot because I'm crouching there for like almost an hour. I wanted this to end fast. So here is the angle from the top view. Yeah, I'm lazy to edit that, so I'll just keep it like that. In this last attempt, I wrote this with the intention to make it into a slide to post it on Instagram. The emphasis was put to each line's main character by making the word big. The first line emphasizes on love, the second one is dreams, and the third one is protection. As for the fourth line, it carries more meaning compared to the first three because songs are like poems. Here is where I stop and let you enjoy some brush ASMR. As for the second half of the song, the approach and intention are the same, so I'll just leave you to that. And I'm getting really tired recording this. Hopefully this will come out well in post-production, where everything is rendered and made nicer, probably? Question mark?